I'm going to show you how to chat on an IRC server using nothing but Netcat as a client. Netcat is the Swiss Army knife of networking. It basically gives you a raw TCP connection to work with. If you need to install Netcat, on Debian run sudo apt install netcat. If you're in Windows, use Debian on Windows subsystem for Linux. On Mac, use homebrew and run brew install netcat. If you're a member of the DevDungeon Virtual Hackerspace, you'll have access to our Linux mainframe, and Netcat will already be installed if you want to play around or follow along. You can join and become a member at my.devdungeon.com. To connect to the DevDungeon server, I'd run nc irc.devdungeon.com 6667. 6667 is the default port for IRC, and irc.devdungeon.com is part of our DevDungeon infrastructure. For more information, use your web browser and visit my.devdungeon.com. Let me use a bad port intentionally to show you what happens if you have the wrong port. If there's no connection at all, Netcat will simply exit and leave you back at your prompt. So if I change it back to the correct information, irc.devdungeon.com 6667, and run it, it'll just sit there. So the connection is open, and we have an active TCP connection with the server on port 6667. If you wait for a minute and do nothing at all, eventually the server will close the connection with an error, like this. Error, closing link, registration timeout. This error of registration timeout means we did not register fast enough. Usually you have about a minute to perform the registration. Let me reconnect using nc irc.devdungeon.com 6667, and this time I will register before the server closes the link. To register, you tell the server what username you want with the user command and your nickname with the nick command. Your username is used for formal identification with the server, but your nickname is how your name will show up for other users and how they will address you. I want to connect with the username John Q, so I'll enter user John Q, followed by two separate asterisks, followed by a colon and the full name, John Q Hacker. The first parameter is simply your username. You don't need to worry about what the two asterisks mean. The final parameter is your full name. It starts with a colon because you may have spaces in your full name. Next, you need to set your nickname. That's as simple as Nick John Q, or whatever you want your display name to be. Once you're connected, you can retain your username while changing your nickname many times. After the server processes your registration successfully, it will send you the message of the day along with some server information. On this server, the message of the day is here and says, "Welcome to the DevDungeon Virtual Hackerspace." Now at this point, we are not only fully connected via TCP, but we're also registered with the server, and it fully recognizes us as an IRC client. At this point, you can start messaging people, joining channels, and making queries to the server to get information about channels and users. To message someone, use privMessage. For example, privMessage nanodano, hey dano. This will only work if somebody is currently logged into that server with the nickname of nanodano. To get a list of chat rooms, use list, all by itself. To join a channel, like general, use join hashtag general. To chat in a channel, use private message the same way we did before, but instead of giving it a username, give it the channel name. Channels start with the hash sign, and users don't. To get a list of users currently in the general channel, run who hashtag general. To get more information about a user, like the real name they provided, run who is and their username. For example, who is nanodano. Let me send some messages to myself from another account to show you what it looks like when you receive messages while using Netcat as your IRC client. I'll send one message to the general channel and one direct message to my John Q user. In the console, you'll see who sent the message at the beginning of the line, then you'll see the message destination. The destination might be a channel name or it might be your username. If it's a channel name, they sent the message to the channel. If it's your username, you received a direct message. To respond, use the private message command we saw earlier. Private message hashtag general, glad to be here. And private message nanodano, see you later. So now you've got an active client connection to the IRC server. You know how to list the channels and find somewhere to chat. You know how to join a channel. you know how to check who is in a channel, and you know how to send messages to a channel or to a specific user. You're pretty much all set. After you've been connected for a while, you'll receive a notice from the server. It will say ping, followed by some text. On the DevDungeon server, it says ping, colon, irc.devdungeon.com. What you're supposed to do is respond with pong and the same text that the server provided. So I'll send pong, colon, irc.devdungeon.com to let the server know I'm still here and to keep my connection open. If you don't do anything and you ignore the ping, the server will send you a message saying error, closing link, ping timeout. This error of ping timeout means we failed to respond to the server's ping with a pong and the server closed our connection. Now, we'll have to restart our connection from scratch by running a new Netcat process. For a list of more IRC commands, check out the Wikipedia page for List of Internet Relay Chat Commands. If you want to fully understand the IRC standard, refer to RFC 1459 and 2812. I hope you connect to the irc.devdungeon.com server on port 6667 and come say hello in general chat. Before you go, check out some of my products and services. Register and join our virtual hackerspace to get your own email account at devdungeon.com, a chat account, and SSH access to our Linux mainframe, which includes personal web space, Git storage, and other member-only perks. Join at my.devdungeon.com. Take my courses, Working with Binary Data in Python 3 and Deploy Django on Linux. Visit devdungeon.com/courses. Buy my book, Security with Go. Visit devdungeon.com/books. If you use Discord, Kathy is a fun chatbot for your server. Visit kathy.devdungeon.com. If you have a website, sign up with Apora to get notified if your site goes down. Visit apora.net. Bookmark devdungeon.com for reference and learning. Subscribe to the YouTube channel at youtube.com/devdungeon. Donate directly via PayPal at devdungeon.com/donate.